Punahou recently hosted the second annual Brain Symposium, a seminar that presented new ideas on the education of 21st century learners. Here is a look at this year's conference.
I came to the Brain Symposium because I'm always interested in connecting brain to teaching, and it's right here at Punahou, and we've got a great speaker, Dr. David Eagleman, and it just seemed to be a wonderful way to spend 2 days of summer vacation.
I think there are several ways that teachers can use brain research to help them teach better. One of them is by looking at how the digital brain is different from the kind of brain they grew up on. Things have changed a lot in terms of the technologies that children grow up on, and that changes the way that teachers need to address their students. So in terms of things like taking the best that video games have to offer, and also dealing with the way that kids are used to taking in information now. They also need to understand basic issues of brain science, like why sleep is important for the brain, and encourage their students to get good sleep practices, because that's what consolidates information. And finally, I think the important thing for teachers to do is to teach their children how to think creatively, as opposed to merely regurgitating information for a test.
The coolest thing that I've learned through the presentations is I just sat in on a presentation about stress and the adolescent brain, and I learned that stress is actually a good thing for the brain. If a child knows how to have or to deal with the stress. And so for me, what that translates for is that my arena is teaching yoga, and what yoga does is it helps children learn tools and techniques for dealing with their stress. So it allowed me to realize that I'm moving in the right direction in terms of what I'm doing and how I'm educating youth.
What's happened with technology is students of this generation are used to fast, interactive, multimedia ways of getting information. And it's what we call just-in-time learning as opposed to just-in-case learning. So traditionally, we learned lots of things just in case they became useful later. And students have a more natural learning style now of getting just-in-time information. As they're surfing Wikipedia, they click on the links and drill down where they need to and surf back up to find themselves wherever. But they're following their own interests. It's a choose-your-own-adventure situation.
I teach in the academy. I teach computer science, both the intro to computer science and the AP computer science courses. I came to the Brain Symposium because I wanted to learn more about what the research was showing about how games affect learning, and how exposure to digital technology affects the brain.
I think this gives a real opportunity for schools to keep up by, for example, using video games as homework assignments, in the sense that what you really want to do, what teachers really should be doing, is keeping their students exactly at the individual's point of struggle, meaning where things are just hard enough but they're still achievable. The opportunity afforded here is for video games that are adaptive to keep students exactly where they should be, and schools should be leveraging the opportunities for video games as much as they can to keep students right at that point.
I think one of the coolest things that I learned is that exposure to any kind of stimulus actually causes physiological changes in the brain. So as we're exposed to more kinds of digital technology or experiences, they actually are changing the way our brains develop when we're kids.
Dr. Eagleman is talking about how the neuroplasticity of the brain means you can take a brain and dump it in any culture and it adapts and it learns from its environment.
I think the biggest importance for technology is how we can use it. Because I don't think it's really a question of if we use technology, because the kids that I see they're growing up with technology and they're using it pretty much in every facet of their lives. So I think that it's tremendously important for us as educators to understand how technology changes the way we learn and find ways to use it in positive ways.
Educators will always be in this game of catching up, but I think all that educators need to do is make sure that the students have the tools they need. The important thing, more than ever, is to teach students how to think critically, how to judge the quality of an information source, how to be interested and engaged in a problem, and how to pay attention to something for a long period of time. I think all that educators need to do is teach those general issues, and the students will keep themselves on the cutting edge of the technology.